Our aim is to do two scanning technique. First, you want to find the thoracic paramedian interlaminar space, and secondly, you want to do rib counting. So the first image that you have to embed in your mind is this image. Okay, this is right thoracic paramedian interlaminar view. So this is the lamina, this is the lamina, this is possibly the posterior complex and anterior complex. When you see some insonation of image anteriorly, this could be where the ligamentum flavum and dura is located. Because I have to tell that lamina of the thoracic region is almost similar to facet view of the thoracic region. Okay, it's just a matter of turning the probe obliquely by about 10 degrees. Okay, same spot, you look at it perpendicular like this, you would see nothing insonation, no insonation underneath the space, and that's probably the facet. And if you just turn it by 10 degrees, you would see some structure underneath. You can see? Can you see? And the structure is not directly opposite the opening, because why? The arrangement of lamina is such that it's on top of each other. Okay, that's why the insonation goes this way. Right? So this structure is most probably the posterior complex, this is the anterior complex, and if you want to do it real time, your tohi needle have to come with its introducer attached, very near to this end, tip in full view, and you lift the probe and do LOR technique, if you're alone, right? And patient has to be in sitting position, proper sitting position, so that a flexion of the spine will open up the space, right? Not this position, this is for teaching purpose, okay? Okay, secondly, how do you confirm that this is lamina? If you scan lateral, you would see this structure, which is the transverse process, paravertebral space. If you just do this, you would optimize. If you're actually doing the procedure, you should optimize the view so that this useless window of or sector of the ultrasound gets eliminated. It empowers your view to get a better insonation of your needle. Okay. So now, and as we go more lateral, this is costo transverse junction, and as you go more lateral, this is the ribs. Okay, so now let's do rib counting, because you want to know where exactly you're putting it, isn't it? So now, if you remember the station earlier, you have three paramedian view. One is paramedian transverse process view, where you get to see the overlying paraspinalis muscle and the psoas muscle underneath. This is the spinous transverse process, lumbar spine transverse process, and the shadow underneath. As you go more medial, you get to see the second view, which is the articulating process view, articulating facet view, lumbar articulating facet view, and as you turn oblique, you would see the lumbar interlaminar view with the anterior complex and posterior complex in full view. This is possibly the epidural space. So mind you, this space and articulating view and the lamina view is quite distinct, but thoracic lamina and facet is not distinct, so more similar. So when you hit the bone in thoracic epidural, you may redirect medially so that you hit the epidural space. Okay, so now let's do rib counting again. You would see the paramedian transverse view and scan upwards until you reach the point where you see another bigger structure above, and the spinous process kind of disappearing, getting thin. So concentrate on this structure and scan more lateral. So you get to see that it becomes superficial on top of the right kidney and nothing underneath. There's no spinous process underneath. There's no. So this means that this structure is almost certainly 12 rib. Okay. So start counting 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7. So put 7 in the midline. 7 in the midline. And you see, this corresponds to the tip of scapula. You get your T7 and scan medially. So that is your T7 in the middle. So you scan medially and you get 7 lamina and 8. This is the inter lamina, your target. Okay, scan. So you can do rib counting first, or you can do interim. Maybe you can do rib counting first. Yeah. So patient has to be in a sitting, proper sitting position. The back is fully flexed so that you get the space open up. Are you sure? I didn't notice you're here. Okay, get to paramedian transverse process view. Lumbar paramedian transverse process view. So you come in the lumbar region from lateral to midline. Scan from lateral to midline. So the first view that you get is the trident view. More lateral. Yes, so that's your lumbar transverse process. Scan upwards, scan up. All right, you see this structure? Okay, more lateral, scan lateral. Okay, nothing else underneath, and this structure persistent, and scan up.
Thanks.
No worries.